A link will be provided when the experience starts. Then you'll be experience the story in your browser. We recommend using headphones and turning off all other programs for the best experience. Please update your browser as well. There will be questions regarding your political, cultural, and economical views. Please note that your response to these questions will not be saved and are simply used as parameters for sound creation on the website. These questions are based on an online political contest test, and results are just for your reference. There will be key decision-making moments throughout the story, which will alter the fate of the characters. This key decision shall be made as a collective with other participants. The decision-making process shall be moderated by us, allowing 1.5 minutes for every participant to voice out their opinions, and a 6-minute free discussion among all participants, in which you will question opposing parties, and making this decision ultimately by poll. To facilitate the process, please use the raise hand function in the reaction section. The reaction button is located next to the record button. So please raise your hand if you have finished reading each chapter of the story. Each chapter is approximately a 5 to 10 minutes read. There's a timer at the lower right-hand corner to notify your reading progress. The decision-making process shall not begin until everyone has finished reading their chapter. So please keep your own time when you read the chapter. You will be muted for the entire section of the experience except for your time to voice opinions, except the free discussion sections. The experience will be streamed to the SoundsAbout Twitch channel. The discussion section will be broadcast live online. If you have privacy or safety concerns, you're encouraged to use anonymous names. Close your camera or cover your face during the experience. You may opt out of the experience if you wish, but please give us a heads up if you do. Please raise your hand if you understand everything. Mara, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. I'm okay.
Okay.
Cool. The link is now on the chat box. Please proceed to the story. Welcome and enjoy. Please click to continue the session. Understood. If you see the initializing message, please click to continue.
The human race. Thank you.
You may use the mouse click and spacebar to speed up the text if it is too slow. We're still waiting for PIN. especially from our... Thank you. First of all, I would like to invite all of us to do a polling on what decision to make. Tomorrow, remember you to raise your hand if you finish the story. Here's the result. Now I would like to ask each of you to share your choice and the reason behind the choice. First, let us start with Left Winter.
Freedom.
Yes, and why would you choose that?
I suppose a robot doesn't have freedom because they are assigned specific tasks only. And so the difference in somebody who has freedom and doesn't have freedom will surely be a human.
Thank you very much. Let us move to the next one. See Ka Yen.
Hello, can you hear me? Hello? Yeah. I chose function because I think as a human, we cannot do everything. But if a robot, if we insert any programs or specific tasks, I think a robot can finish any task. So I think, function can define if that figure is a human or an artificial one.
Thank you very much. And the next Xi Jinping.
Well, I think that Humans and robots, the difference between them should always be the intelligence, because robots, they're just pieces of metal. I don't think they have anything to do with intelligence, because we tell them what to do, and that's what they can do. They can't think about anything other than what we tell them to think. So intelligence is what differs us between the robots and us, because we have human brains are much highly complex things that are more complex than normal computers can do. So definitely, we are much smarter than those pieces of metals.
Thank you very much. So after we heard each other's opinion, it is now a 6 minutes free discussion section. I would like to invite everyone to question and discuss with those with a different choice. Please try to convince opposing parties.
Hello. Hello, everybody.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hey.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Intelligence. What happens if a robot eventually has the same level of intelligence as a human?
Is that possible?
That is not possible, because we tell them what to do. That's not even possible.
Is anything not possible?
Well, we can, of course, if they can learn by itself, then that would be something that is against God's will. I think that we are only capable of making something that is only on par to what we can do. They can't have the same amount of intelligence as us, because that's what God made.
So I suppose in the 1940s, we hadn't ever put anybody on the moon, which was seemingly impossible. And we achieved that. So I suppose you just don't know what's around the corner. And what happens if something came to us from a different galaxy, a life form? Would that be more intelligent without the God?
But we'll never know what's beyond the stars, because it's something that it's unknowable. But I think even if making something like that is possible, but then robots, that's what we made. And we can limit what they are capable of.
But do we have to define what intelligent means before?
Yes, good point.
Yeah. Because I was just thinking, intelligence, shall we, let's say that, intelligence means you can do problem solving very well, or you can think things deeply, philosophically. I don't know. I don't have I don't have an answer right now. But I guess this is how to define intelligence can be a point to discuss.
Yeah. To me, I think intelligence is how smart we are. We are able to think things that are way beyond what a normal computer could think. Normally, I don't think computers can think, because we just tell them what to do and they do it. And that is what distinguishes us from them, because they don't really know how to think.
But then if you look at humans, you get some humans who are extremely intelligent, and you get some humans who are extremely unintelligent. Would you agree with that?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
So, I mean, I'm of the opinion that all humans are slowly being dumbed down. I think as a being, I think the majority are becoming less intelligent, whether that's through no access to education or something else. But it seems to be that en masse we're fed information, sound bites, and we accept them. The majority don't develop.
But then would you think the other way? Like some of us humans have more freedom, but then some of us has less freedom. But then comparing to the robots, like are like humans have that have less freedom are on par with the robots because what they do is what we tell them to do, or they're just plain stupid.
I mean, that's an interesting point. I mean, Chim, I think in terms of some humans have got much less freedom. So humans who are imprisoned or in poverty have very little freedom, but they potentially still have their intelligence.
But then are they robots then?
Yes.
You don't even have that.
Yes. I mean, I think if you're in imprisoned, incarcerated for life, doing hard labor, where you're starved of emotional contact and everything else, if you're in solitary confinement, then I suppose you don't have freedom. And then you are no longer a human, in a sense. If that makes sense. I'm not sure if it does.
Thank you for the sharing. Sorry, I missed Mauro's turn. Mauro, would you mind sharing with us your choice and the reason?
My opinion on that topic?
All the choices you made.
I choose intelligence because I think that the difference between the machines and the intelligent machines and the human being are that intelligent machines make decisions with limited amount of choices, and we have we are able to create infinity kind of choices. So for me, this makes us like free beings in some way.
Thank you, Maru. Now we have heard opinions from all parties. Let's make the final decision. And here's the result. It seems the results are close, but the majority of you, at least half of you guys, choose freedom. Let's proceed back to the story. Welcome back, everyone. First of all, I would like to invite all of us to do the initial polling. Here's the result. Now I would like to ask Maru to share his choice and the reason behind.
I choose justice.
I choose justice because I guess without justice there is no civilization. We cannot live together, and there is no freedom without justice. The freedom has limits. On the limits is the others.
Thank you, Maru. Now I would like to invite Lev Winter.
Justice. Justice because it's based on a system of ethics and law that means that people can behave in a way that is fair and balanced for everybody. That's it.
Thank you. See you.
Freedom. I think it's freedom because if there is no freedom in a country, let's say, nothing can be improved, and so there will be no efficiency, I guess, and if there is no freedom, Yeah, to me, I think freedom is about justice. Yeah. We need to, that means we can do whatever we can then, to not restrict what people should be. Yeah.
Thank you, Sikaian. And now, Xi Jinping.
Well, I think that still, we can think about freedom, we can think about justice, but everything stems from efficiency. Without efficiency, I mean, justice is based on the concept of efficiency because we need laws, we need these strict rules to run the society, to make it like more efficient in a way everyone should follow the law, follow the rule of law, follow with everything. It stems from the very concept of efficiency because when we do things, when the law can actually control what is right and what is wrong, it actually makes like everything towards efficient society, because then we can just like punish the bad people that does the bad things, and make the society better.
Thank you, Xi. Now we have heard each other's opinion. Time for the free discussion section.
So let me continue with my point there, because I personally think efficiency is what drives the society to a better place. And actually the law and the justice, it's just used as a tool to enforce the efficiency, because then we can punish the bad, we can give good people what the rewards they have, and then we can just quickly pull out at everything according to the justice system. And then in the end, it's all about efficiency.
If it's all about efficiency, then, and it's not about justice, then if there were no justice, there would be lawlessness or anarchy. And lawlessness and anarchy must surely be completely inefficient.
But that's what I meant. We are making justice with efficiency. Our system of justice should be made on the basis of efficiency.
So you're saying efficiency comes first and justice comes second. It's like chicken and egg, isn't it? Which came first, I suppose?
Probably. But then efficiency is what, we can shape our own version of justice to make the society run better, because that's, we know what is right and what is wrong, but some people are just not smart enough to know what's good for them and what's not. And that's why we need to present our concept of justice to them. And that's all about efficiency.
Tricky. Obviously the question was civilization, wasn't it? And what makes a civilization, I suppose. What does make a civilization? And, if a civilization is settlements and cities and towns and so on, then do they have to be efficient?
But then civilization has to grow, and if the civilization doesn't grow, it will be destroyed. Everything will whittle into nothing, and that's why we need efficiency to help it grow further and further.
I mean, I suppose some civilizations, die out. Ancient civilizations have obviously been and gone. I suppose there are civilizations now that still exist, which warrant the term description civilization, but they don't grow, I don't suppose, because they just remain insular. Villages that are locked and isolated away from the outside world, which still exist. So, I suppose, they're efficient because they're self-sustainable. But are they more efficient because of the fact that within that civilization, justice exists?
We'll never know, because we're never part of their civilization. But then nowadays, we're as part of the world that our civilization, not the civilizations that are so isolated from the world, those civilizations that we are so interconnected, is basically, we have to continue our growth, continue our efficiency in order to sustain it, because those who does not connect with the world would just eventually be forgotten.
If we focus on growth, I guess freedom is actually very important for people to be able to be efficient or to invent or to improve things in the society. Because if in a country, if there is no freedom, then people cannot do whatever they like or they prefer, then how can we talk about efficiency?
So what you're saying is freedom is something that could allow people, allow civilization to grow. But then,
yes.
Civilization, what, but how does freedom help it? Like, because it doesn't contribute anything, not to growth, not to economy. It's just people want to do whatever they want and they would eventually destroy everything.
I guess maybe I said that under the belief of everyone is a good person. Yeah. So they won't do bad things, they do things for the society. But yeah. Maybe I have to rethink what I was saying.
I would agree, it is a shell, chicken or egg. But we have come to the point that we have to make the final decision for this choice. And here's the result. We have collectively decided justice as the most important foundation of the civilization. Now, please go back to the story.
The human race over the Every person has worth. Every person matters. Every person deserves to be treated with decency and respect. We must uphold the inherent dignity of every human being. Dignity. That basic idea that by virtue of our common humanity, no matter where we come from or what we look like, we are all born equal
and you must touched by the grace of God. That all forms
every person has worth. Every person matters. Every person deserves to be treated with decency and respect. We must uphold the inherent dignity of every human
that
being.
All forms of direct democracy are dangerous.
Dignity. That basic idea that by virtue of our common thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome back, everyone. Let's make the initial polling. And here's the results. It's interesting. So, shall I invite Sikai in first to share her choice?
My choice is no. I wouldn't talk to Radius. Because I think Radius has its own intelligence and thinking to decide what he wants to do. That's all. Then.
Thank you very much, Maru.
Can you hear me? Okay. Can you,
Maru,
can you
hear me? Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect. My choice is
no.
Radius is a robot. You don't need to talk with robots. You just make orders. It doesn't matter what it has feeling or whatever. It's or some kind of intelligence.
And left winter.
He's a robot. He wants power. He wants more intelligence. And so then in that case, Radius is worth speaking with and reasoning with.
Oh, so you choose yes.
Mm-hmm.
To reason.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much. And Xi Jinping?
So, no, I'm not going to talk with Radius since, well, this robot was surprisingly had intelligence while we were just talking about that he won't have robots couldn't have intelligence. But I guess, okay, we found a way to make robots intelligent. But then that's the scary part, because he thinks about it and then he decides to attack us. Isn't that horrible? But then in nature, he has intelligence and he kind of looks like a human, but then in the end, he isn't, because we created them and we are supposed to order them to do this and do that. But then they went out and attacked us. That's quite terrifying. And like, we need to be very clear that they are not going to become humans because they can't. That if they are really humans, they will be psychopaths going out attacking everyone. And they should really be jailed. But then since they are not really lives, then I think we can do whatever we want with them.
Okay, thank you. Left Winter, do you have anything to say to those who choose no?
Yes. it appears that life is headed towards a universal income, which is essentially efficiency. Humans will have freedom, they'll have justice, and robots will provide the utopia. And so you need to reason. You can't deny that that's going to happen. You can't say, no, I'm going to shut it out. You have to discuss. You have to talk. There's no point in threatening. And there's no point in appeasing. So suppose at least you could aim for a good conclusion for all.
Thank you very much.
But then do you think they could be reasoned to? I mean, they just went out attacking us. If that's the way they behave, then that those people are just aggressive. Those robots are aggressive, I mean.
But then humans are aggressive. And, you know, we talk about civilizations. Civilizations destroy civilizations that they don't like. Humans naturally destroy what they don't like. Other nationalities, other cultures, other ideologies. And they make ideologies to control and so on. I think from the story that I've just read, it's almost a utopia. And so I suppose if robots did all choose to attempt to destroy humans, then that would then be just another battle for humans, wouldn't it? But is that likely? And if it is likely, then surely reasoning is the only way forward. It's diplomacy, I suppose.
Any objections? Thank you, Left Winter.
Okay.
I appreciate your choice.
We are, since humans are also aggressive, then, I mean, what we're, but by trees choosing no, we're actually being aggressive to robots. But then, what you're saying is like, you're accepting the fact that humans are aggressive as well, or I don't quite get it, actually.
Yes, humans are aggressive.
And do you think it's okay for humans to destroy other civilizations?
No. But they do, and have done since they walked the Earth.
But then what we're facing now is that Radius is trying to overrun us. For our own good?
Well, potentially, because if as what it appears, that it's talking about the price of goods becomes low, it means that man no longer has to slave to earn a crust. It means that man presumably has freedom and just enjoys. And robots, machines, do all of the work. It's the aristocracy for humans, isn't it?
It is. But given that if robots don't become more human and start attacking us, that's what's happening.
Hence, reasoning. It can't be stopped, can it? Or can it? And saying no isn't going to stop it.
Do you think we can reason with people that attacks us? Like, physically attacking us?
Eventually, I think. I mean, it's a sensitive subject, isn't it? I think if you are, as an individual, about to be assaulted in the street or, you know, minding your own business in a gallery or a restaurant, and somebody wishes to attack you, then I suppose fight or flight kicks in. But then I suppose, could you reason your way out of being attacked?
I think, according to his behavior. He doesn't seem to be something that has... When you're facing an absolute force that doesn't listen to anything, like, he just simply struggles, and he doesn't want to listen to you, then how do you respond?
Well, no would be just to give up, wouldn't it? I mean, I'd rather die trying, if that makes sense.
I see.
Sounds awful, that, doesn't it? Sorry.
Okay, time to make the final decision. And here's the result. Seems we have to decide again. So, does anyone got anything to say before we make the final polling?
If I could just add one more thing. I think the ability to be able to reason, the ability to be able to speak to your worst enemy must be an advantage. History has done that, you know, in famous or infamous situations, but we have to sit down and talk. If we don't, then there isn't anything, is there?
Thank you very much. We have now come to a conclusion. We have collectively decided to choose yes to reason with radius. Now, please go back to the story. Welcome back, everyone. Let us make the initial polling. Here's the result. Since we have a landslide victory, so but still, let's explain our choices. Let's start with Sinaye.
Yeah, the blueprint shouldn't be burnt because we have to maintain the truth. To tell people in the future or at the present to know what actually have happened, and we should learn from the mistakes. Yeah.
Thank you, and Maru.
Yeah.
There are documents. Burn it, it's erase a memory. Yeah, I agree with Sayaka-han.
Thank you. And Left Winter?
Yeah, I agree with the previous two. I think burning anything is... it's not a good route. It's always good to keep something as evidence.
Xi Jinping.
I think it's a good idea to keep the blueprints as like the robots are acting now. They're just like malfunctioning in some way. There's some flaws in the blueprints, and I think all we have to do is find a way to make it efficient, more efficient, make it work functioning as what we intended to. So, and imagine like all the labor and all the wars being fought by the robots, but then. Since they are actually attacking people now, I think we should like keep these blueprints definitely to find out what's the problem in the process and fix it.
Thank you. And I think we don't need the second polling. So I think you guys have collectively decided to choose no, not to burn the blueprint. Let's go back to the story.
The house and the homeland. human race over the nuclear race. Our mission, to feed the hungry, to clothe the naked, to house the homeless, to teach the illiterate, to provide jobs for the jobless, and to choose the human race over the nuclear race. To feed the hungry, to clothe the naked, to house the homeless, to teach the illiterate, where we come from, to provide jobs.
What do you look like?
And you must recognize that
you're all born equal.
All forms of direct democracy are dangerous.
Every person has worth. Every person matters. Every person deserves to be treated with decency and respect. We must uphold the inherent dignity of every human being. Dignity. That basic idea is by virtue of our common humanity, no matter where we come from or what we look like, we are all born equal.
And you must
by the grace of God. Every person has worth. Every person matters. Every person deserves to be treated with decency and respect. We must uphold the inherent dignity of every human being.
All forms of direct democracy are dangerous.
Dignity. That basic idea that by virtue of our common humanity, no matter where we come from, or what we look like,
democracy are dangerous.
We are all born equal. Touched by the
As before, see Kayan for a little bit. Welcome back, everyone. Let's make the last choice for the experience. And here is the result. I would like to first invite Xi Jinping to explain his choices.
So I chose sell because we need to sell the blueprints to them. They can't be reasoned to for now. All they have been doing is just killing all the people, and we're in like a very dire situation where everyone's surrounded. Well, since we can't reason with them, since they're all fired up on killing us instead, we can just simply state our like conditions. We have this blueprint that you have that have your survival, like your survival will depends on this blueprint here. Then we make our own terms by giving you this. They would let us live, and they can give us an island where we can live there forever, and that's basically, and we can just cut our ties with all these barbarians that tries to kill everyone. I don't think we can reason with them anymore.
Thank you very much. And the next, Maru, would you mind sharing your choice?
My choice is negotiate. because we cannot fight, of course, but selling the blueprints to them, I don't think it's a good idea, because then they can build more, and but negotiation, we can ask for it. I'm quite agree with Winter has said, but I guess that he was talking about negotiation rather than selling the blueprints. I'm not right.
Yeah, I haven't spoken yet.
Sorry. No.
I think you mean Chim.
Chim Pingy. Yeah. Sorry.
It's okay.
Thank you very much. So, shall I now invite Left Winter to finish with?
Yeah, I'm always prepared to fight and ready to fight, but I'd negotiate until the very, very last moment. I don't think I'd sell. Selling doesn't feel right, so I'd negotiate.
Thank you, and see Kaye.
I chose negotiate too, because I think if we just sell it, there is only one result. But if we negotiate it, you never know what will bring us. Yeah, if we take the action to talk further. So I think negotiate is the most important.
Thank you very much. So, Xi, do you have anything to discuss to your opposing parties?
So, there might be some confusions, like selling and negotiating. It's kind of like close, right? But then I think my stand here is to like give a deal to the robots. We give you the blueprints, you let us go, we live our own lives, they live theirs. And that's the point I want to make. Because they can't really be reasoned with. And so in this case, then let's just put down a deal and we go home safe.
Does anyone have anything to say with she?
I mean, that is not a negotiation. You're giving the blueprints, and you're asking for freedom or just life.
But then we have to live, like, or else we all die. Like, but then if you're trying to negotiate with them, then how do you propose to negotiate with them?
I agree with you. I will change it for keep my life. But selling, I don't know. I'm quite confused, I guess.
I think selling something, you're essentially selling something to somebody that you don't trust. And I kind of imagine a James Bond film where you'd end up selling something, and then as you were walking out of the building, you'd get shot in the back. Whereas I think negotiating will probably give you the very best.
Not leaving until we give you
the very best opportunity to try and get what you want, I guess. Before you fight.
But then they have all the guns pointing at us already. Like, what? How do we present? Like, what else can we get from a negotiation other than like this deal that I'm presenting? That I can just like, here's your life and like we can exchange your life with ours. Like, I think, is there other options than this?
No, probably not. But then I don't understand what we would gain from selling.
But then essentially that what we propose in the negotiation would more or less be the same, like the same as selling, because like it's just giving them their what they want and they give what we want.
I suppose.
But I think selling in this situation is like giving up.
I have the same impression. It's giving up.
But what do we want more from them? Like, we are essentially giving up because everyone's pointing our guns at us, and I think life is more important than anything.
I think it's better to die trying. I mean, negotiating, you're not giving up. I agree with the last point. I think selling, you are. Whereas negotiating, you are literally doing something till the very, 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 very end.
Yeah.
then what are we trying to gain more than our lives? Are we striving for something? Freedom. Freedom. So you think if we negotiate with them, we can have a chance of gaining freedom when these people, like these robots here, are using guns to point at us?
Yeah. Possibly, yeah.
Sorry, see, you were dropping out. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, hello. Yeah, I said
you were speaking just now.
I agree. Yes, I said there will be a chance, yeah, to win, I say. If we negotiate.
Okay, time has come to make the final decision. This is the result. I think the majority of the rogue still goes to negotiate. Please go back to the story.
Okay, sorry guys, I think we have a bug. at the end? Let's come back to the WebEx section.